household name in America. George was always very modest about his first great success, which was September in the Rain. He always said, well, it sold 900,000 copies. By the time he was going to say that, it was well past the million mark, but being George, he liked just to play that down very slightly. How on earth did I meet George and end up writing his life story with him? Well, it's all to do with the BBC. He came up to Pebble Mill to record an episode of a programme I used to do called Jazz Mix, and the idea was that we'd sit at the Steinway and he'd tell me his life story. Well, things got off to a very bad start, because the chap that Steinway had sent out to tune the piano had had a very good lunch. And the piano was far from in tune. So George said, well, we'll get going. Once the piano tune has been, and this voice from the thing said, well, unfortunately, George said, no, you haven't. Took the hammer from you and retuned the central octave as he wished it to be played. So I knew then that George was very serious about pianos and piano tuning. We sat down and he started playing a piece called Mighty Like the Blues. The reason being, it was the very first piece he played on BBC Radio in the 1930s. And the story started to flow. He started telling me his life story and playing it at the piano as he went along. So we heard things that he played with Bill Bampton's blind band in the 30s. And then a remarkable piece, which was called Delayed Action. And it's a musical portrait of one of the time bombs that landed on London during the Blitz and went off with Delayed Action. Actually, musically, it was borrowed from Fats Waller. It's Alligator Call by a different name. And I mentioned this to George. He said, oh, Fats Waller. I met him in London in 1938. Hands like bananas. Apparently when he shook hands, he said he felt the fingers, and he felt a bit more, and a bit more, and the fingers just went on. This is a man who could stretch a 13th on the piano, so quite sizable hands.